Welcome to the introduction to the principles and practice of clinical research. My name is Serena Chu, and I'm a scientific review officer in the Institute of Mental Health. I'm going to present one module in a series of four. My topic today will center on the peer review process. In my talk today, I'm going to cover the main components of research project awards and career award applications. I'll also briefly discuss some of the mechanisms that might be of the most interest to early stage and new investigators. So a question that many of you may wonder about is, what determines which applications are awarded? And a number of factors kind of go into this consideration. First, the overall impact score is one of the most important variables, although a great scoring application is no guarantee that an application will be funded. Each institute also has its own pay line, and the pay line may vary depending on the type of application being considered. For early stage investigators, they are sometimes afforded a more liberal pay line than more established investigators. Programmatic considerations also factor into which applications get funded. For example, an institute might pass over an application that scored better and to fund a worse scoring application because it focuses on a priority area for that institute. Many institutes publish their priority areas on their website, and I really encourage you to take advantage of those resources. The availability of funds also play a role. For example, money might already be committed to ongoing projects or for certain requests for applications, so this may limit which funds are available to new applications. I will briefly go over the main sections of a research project application. And this isn't an exhaustive list of the sections, but just the ones I think are important for you to be aware of. If you're resubmitting an application, you're allowed up to one page to address comments that were raised in the previous review. The specific aims, which is supposed to serve as a snapshot of your project, is also limited to one page. The next main section is the research strategy. Since the R01 is a larger project, this mechanism is afforded more pages in this section than smaller mechanisms, such as an R21 or R03. But regardless of mechanism, most applications are focused on five main criteria. The significance involves the importance of the work if it's successful. The innovation involves the novelty of what is being proposed. The investigator is centered on the qualifications of the team for completing the work. The approach pertains to the scientific rigor of the design. And finally, the environment reflects the facilities and resources that will be available to the study. There should be a discussion of preliminary studies that are pertinent to the application. And this is important for establishing the likelihood of success for the proposed project. Okay. In the facilities and other resources section, you should describe how the scientific environment will contribute to the probability of success. For example, ways in which the proposed studies will benefit from unique features of the scientific environment, or from unique subject populations, or how studies might employ useful collaborative arrangements. For early stage investigators, you can describe institutional investment in your success, such as resources for classes, collegial support, such as career enrichment programs, logistical support, such as administrative management. And then moving on to the bio sketch, you should include one for all senior and key personnel or other significant contributors. The bio sketch should not exceed 5 pages per person. The personal statement should be crafted to describe why you are well-suited for your role on the project. When completing the contribution to science section, briefly describe up to 5 of your most significant contributions to science. For each contribution, you may cite up to 4 publications of research products that are relevant for the contribution. There are two primary types of budget forms, the modular budget form and the detailed research and related budget form, also known as the R&R. Generally, you would use the R&R budget form if you're applying for more than $250,000 in budget period and direct costs. Modular budgets are simplified, therefore detailed categorical information doesn't need to be submitted. If you're using live vertebrate animals, please provide a concise description of the proposed procedures to be used. You also have to provide justification that the species are appropriate for the proposed research. And then finally, discuss plans to minimize pain and distress, such as the use of anesthesia that will minimize discomfort. Refer to the FOA to determine whether there are any special appendix instructions for your application. In general, a maximum of 10 FDA attachments is permitted. However, the only allowable materials are blank collection forms, sample interview questions, and blank informed consent forms. Other items are only allowed if they're specified in the FOA. Everyone must complete the use of human subjects and/or data section. Each study within an application should be unique and have a different study title. Each study record is divided into numbered sections. For example, Section 1, Basic Information, should include a descriptive study title. Section 2, Study Population Characteristics, should include information such as your inclusion exclusion criteria. Section 3, Protection and Monitoring Plans. This should include the description of the risks of participants and what protections will be in place against these risks. In Section 4, Protocol Synopsis, if you're submitting a clinical trial, you have to provide a narrative description of the protocol, such as the primary purpose of the trial, the intervention, outcome measures, statistical design and power. And then finally, in Section 5, other clinical trial related attachments. For clinical trials, you can attach documents that your FOA specifies are required or permitted. Please be sure to not duplicate information in the research strategy and the human subjects and clinical trials information form, or this might be interpreted as overstuffing. The purpose of the Career Development Award program is to provide candidates at the undergraduate, graduate, postdoctoral, early career, and mid-career stages with opportunities to build on their initial research training and to further develop their research careers through individual or institutional awards. The NIH has a great website that allows applicants to search by career level. There are also separate announcements for studies involving clinical trials. A number of the awards provide protected supervised career development time. I just want to highlight some of the more popular K awards that are available. The KO1 provides support and a supervised research development experience for applicants early in their careers. Some institutes use this mechanism to enhance diversity or to provide training to individuals who have taken a hiatus in their research careers. KO2 provides protected time for investigators who are newly independent and have peer-reviewed support, normally at the R01 level or the equivalent. The KO8 provides an opportunity for clinically trained applicants to receive supervised career development in basic clinical and translational research. This does not include patient-oriented research. Okay. For the K22, this award is to help investigators transition to an independent research career. This might be in the form of a 1 or 2 phase award. For the 2-phase award, this might be an initial period of mentored research followed by a period of independent research. For the K23, this is to provide investigators with a clinical doctoral degree, supervised research development support for conducting patient-oriented research. The K24 is to provide established investigators, normally defined at being at the associate level or higher, protected time to conduct patient-oriented research and to serve as mentors in this area to more junior investigators. The K25 is to provide those with advanced degrees in quantitative science and engineering research with supervised career development in NIH-relevant research. And finally, for the K99 award, this is to assist postdoctoral researchers transition to independent tenure-track faculty positions. Applicants can receive 1 to 2 years of mentored research support and then 3 years of independent research support. So there's a lot of similarity between the format of the career awards and the research awards. For example, resubmissions are allowed, 1-page introduction, which gives you the candidate an opportunity to respond to the previous review. The main part of the application is in the candidate information and goals for research for career development attachment and the research plan attachments. These attachments include information on the candidate's background, such as how their past scientific history fits with past and future research career development. Their career goals and objectives describe the candidate's short and long-term goals. And the career development and training activities describe the new or enhanced research skills that the candidate will acquire as a result of the proposed award. The research plan includes the specific aims attachment, which is limited to one page and summarizes the goals of the proposed research and the expected outcomes. There is also a research strategy attachment that addresses main research criteria, namely significance, innovation, and approach. Also important to many career awards are reference letters. For the mechanisms that require reference letters, at least 3, but no more than 5 letters are required. Who will be supplying the reference letters should be listed in your cover letter. Reference letters must be submitted directly to ERA Commons. In terms of how career awards are reviewed, there are some similarities, but also noticeable differences in how research applications are reviewed. The overall score reflects a likelihood that the proposed research development will enhance the candidate's potential for a productive, independent, scientific career in the health-related field. The candidate is important to consider. That is, the candidate's potential to develop into an independent and productive researcher. The career development plan is judged on the likelihood that the plan will contribute to the scientific development of the candidate. The research plan reflects the strength of the research design and methodology. The mentors and collaborators reflect the qualifications of the mentors in the proposed area of research, as well as their record of success in fostering the development of independent investigators. Regarding the environment, there should be clear commitment from the sponsoring institution of supporting the career development of the candidate. Similar to the research applications, human subject inclusion and vertebrate animals are criteria that can impact the score. In terms of considerations that don't impact the score, but can be raised by reviewers, the training of the responsible conduct of research pertains to candidates receiving training and the practice of scientific investigation with integrity. Another program that might be of interest to early career investigators is the Loan Repayment Program. There is an extramural program for research that is performed outside of NIH and an intramural program for research performed inside NIH. There's overlap in both programs regarding the focus of clinical research for individuals from disadvantaged backgrounds, but otherwise the focus areas differ. The program will repay up to $50,000 per year for 2 years of education debt in exchange for 1 to 2 years of research. Applicants have to be a U.S. citizen. There is only one deadline per year, so be sure to consult the website for the latest deadline. Applicants can submit a new award, or if you're already funded, you can submit a renewal. Thank you for your time, and I hope you found this information to be useful. Please be sure to view the other modules in this series.